Hi, I'm Pjarek, a developer relations engineer from Google. In this video, I debug a Google Chat app that runs on Node.js with the Express framework in my local environment. I often do this to speed up things when I need to test code changes or when I need to troubleshoot issues. I recommend having a basic knowledge of Node.js and how to build and use chat apps before watching this video. You will find useful links in the description in case you need resources to get started or a quick refresher. You will also find links to similar videos where I debug Google Chat apps that run on Python and Java with the Google Cloud Functions framework. All right, let's start with what I already have set up for this demonstration. I have a Google Workspace account with access to Google Chat. I have Visual Studio Code installed on my local environment. It's configured to allow debugging. I have the latest versions of Node, NPM, and NodeMon installed on my local environment as well. It's required to run the basic app locally and for auto reload. I use Git to clone the source code to my local environment. I did it from the repository Google Chat Samples that is available on GitHub. I set up an ngrok account and registered my local environment. I will use it to connect my local environment to the internet so that the chat app can send requests to it. For that, I created an ngrok account online. I created a static domain from the account and I installed the ngrok application in my local environment. I decided to use a static domain purely for convenience. It's not required. And this is it. Let's move on to the actual demonstration. First, I want to create the chat app I will debug locally. I start by creating a new Google Cloud project from the console. In the project name field, I enter a descriptive name for my project. I go with debug app here. In the location field, I keep the default selection. It's my organization. And that's it. The Google Cloud console navigates to the dashboard page and my project is created within seconds. Done. I can even select it for further configuration directly from the notification box. Next step is to make sure billing is set up for my project. For that, I go to the billing section of my organization and I check if there is a billing account associated with my project under the tab My Projects. This is the case here, so I'm already all set when it comes to billing. If it was not the case, I would have set it up from there. Now, I need to enable and configure the Google Chat API on my project. For that, I can make sure my project is selected, then I go to the API library. I search for the Google Chat API, I select it, and I enable it clicking on the button. After seconds, I'm successfully redirected to the Google Chat API page. I can now start configuring the chat app. In the app name field, I enter debug app. For the avatar URL, I use one from the Google Workspace Developers documentation website. I enter a description. I go with something similar to the app name in this case. Under interactive features, I select all functionalities. For connection settings, I select app URL and enter my ngrok static domain so that the request can eventually be redirected to my local environment. Last but not least, I make this chat app visible to a user of my organization and I enable logging. These settings are often useful when testing and troubleshooting. And this is it. I can save now. Okay, my user should have access to this chat app. I want to test it out. For that, I need to log in with the user account and open Google Chat. I start a new chat and search for the chat app name I configured, debug app. And here it is, as expected. I can create a space with it and send a message. Well, the chat app is non-responsive, but that's completely normal because I do not have anything set to handle the request as of now. Let's fix that. What I want is to run and debug the web app server in my local environment on the port 9000. For that, I start by opening a new Visual Studio Code window with the basic app source code at the root. Then I go to the package.json file and add a few scripts. The first one is named debug. It executes the index.js file using Node in debug mode. The second one is named debug watch. It runs the first script with nodemon for auto reload. The idea is to restart each time there is a change in the source code. Now I'm done with that. I open the index.js file and make sure that the default port used by Express is 9000. This is the case here, so I'm all good. I can now move on and install all the dependencies. I should be ready to start the chat app at this stage. I want to do it from the Visual Studio Code and the debugger. For that, I initiate the launch.json file from the run and debug section, and I add a configuration name debug watch that executes the debug watch script I defined previously. If set correctly, I should be able to start it directly from the UI. All right, I see the process is running and the port 9000 is in use. This is perfect. Now that the chat app is started in my local environment, let's send another message in the chat we started with our user account and test again. Well, it's still unresponsive, but that's expected. The requests are not redirected to my local environment just yet. To fix that, I need to start ngrok in my local environment with the ngrok static domain and the port 9000, which is used by the running web app server. A good way to confirm that ngrok is running is to open its web interface. It's accessible from the port 4040 by default. Here we go. It states that no requests were redirected yet, but that's expected. Now that the requests are redirected to my local environment, let's send yet another message in the chat we started with our user account and test again. And this time it's responding. I can easily confirm that the request was redirected by looking at the ngrok web interface. That's the case. I can see all the details of the request and the response. This is pretty useful for troubleshooting. All right, now that the chat app is running locally, I want to debug it. I add a breakpoint in the main function located in the index.js file. The execution should stop here next time a request is processed. This time I can test by replaying the last request that was redirected by ngrok instead of sending a message from chat. For that, I go to ngrok's web interface, I select the request, and I click on the replay button. The execution paused at the breakpoint as expected. I can now execute the code line by line, check the running context, and resume the execution if I want to. It's worth noting that nothing changed in the chat, even though the request was successfully processed. This is because the request was not sent from chat app, but rather our local ngrok app. Now, the main benefit of debugging locally is to quickly edit and test code changes. For demonstration purposes, let's assume I want to change the response message here. I can do this by editing and saving the source code I have in my local environment. The web app server is automatically restarted because it was started with auto reload. The change I made should be taken into account. I can test by disabling the breakpoint and replaying the last request from ngrok's web interface one more time. As you can see, the change I made was taken into account. I can see the new response in the payload. I love how fast I can iterate on the code and troubleshoot errors with this. You will find links in the description if you want to learn more about debugging and troubleshooting Google Chat apps. Also, make sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel to stay up to date with all things related to the Google Workspace platform. Happy coding!